Jack Conrad is the name they gave when I was born a baby slave. The sugar cane was big and tall. I cut it down with mighty blows. Then came war. All the white men went to fight the rebel cause. The Yankees swept in from the north and claimed the bayou for their own. The Yankees told me I was free. An end had come to slavery. They said, "Honest Abe is calling you." So I put on a coat of blue. We reached Port Hudson by and by. The stars and stripes we held up high. And we laid low their stars and bars when as U.S. colored troops we charged. When war was over, back I came down to the land of sugar cane. I learned that freedom's just a name. Most everything remained the same. A dollar was our daily pay, but I kept working anyway. I married and had children too. Felt like there was nothing I could do. To my boy I gave the name of Grant, the General of Fame. He worked beside me in the fields. We sweated for the sugar yield. We saved our money and we went to Thibodaux, a house to rent. In 1887 came the Knights of Labor Union men. They told us strike for better pay and better lives and better days. Things got heated in the town. The local judge laid his law down. Troops threw strikers off the farms. They sought shelter back uptown. One morning I awoke to sounds of shouting white men all around. We walked outside and saw their guns, and my son Grant commenced to run. They cursed him and they shot him down, shot him through with 20 rounds. My brother tried to run like hell, but they shot him down just as well. And as for me, I tried to hide beneath my house, but still they fired. I've never been so scared before, not even when I went to war. They kept on firing at me, thought I was dead, so let me be. They rode off to the other homes and shot our people one by one. They fired their guns for hours more. The people ran for woods and moor. We never knew how many fell on that November day from hell. I left the next day with my wife, so grateful we were still alive. She died a few months later and I cried until my eyes were dry. I left that day for New Orleans, tried to make a life for me. I told my story to some men. They wrote it down, no more was said. I lived till 1893, in heaven joined my family. And that's the story, what I've told, of the massacre in Thibodaux. I went to work, I went to war, then came back and toiled some more, until we all were laid down low in the town of Thibodaux.